Welcome to JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals. I'm Jamie Scott Okataya here at Telecom Exchange NYC 2016. Joining me today is my friend, Christina Hawatme. She is the founder and CEO of Scopio. Christina, welcome to JSA TV.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
So you launched Scopio earlier this year. Exciting news. Tell us a little bit about your company and the services you provide.
Sure. So Scopio, the website is scope, S-C-O-P dot I-O. We are an effective way to find and use images from social media. We are Getty Images in real time.
I love that, Getty Images in real time.
Yeah.
So what type of companies use your curated photos?
Sure, so any company can search on demand for images they're looking for from social media. It could be anything from a small business that's looking for more real life images. You know, everyone's so desensitized to stock photography, to the most major media and publishers that are looking for real life events like tornadoes or protests or any real time image, maybe like this even.
Right. So. Yeah, right here, these photos from Telecom Exchange can be loaded up to Scopio.
So they're loaded right now.
They are loaded. Great to know. So as a subscriber, what is the process we would go through to find and license some artwork?
Sure. So our value added is really in building content libraries over time. Mm-hmm. So you would be able to capture real life moments like today in the event. You would enter your search, you would say TechSited, Telecom Exchange, and then we would curate that content for you. You're able to go back in time and review that event or ask for permissions for people to use it. Or say you know that you want all like images of pandas, for example, in videos. Then you can search pandas and then build that content library, be able to use it. So it's really whatever you want to search for, and then building these UGC libraries, I mean, people are only engaging with original user-generated content today. They get 40 times more engagement online than a stock photo does.
Wow.
And people only really read about 10% of the text on a page. So that photo is so valuable, and so why not use what people really want to look at instead of that fake family, you know?
Right, right. And then more interaction, marketers love that.
Exactly.
So we can clearly see the value there.
Yeah.
So what big photo trends are you noticing right now? And what do you think the future will hold?
That's such a good question and something that's really interesting right now. So image search is the most difficult problem I think that we're facing today. It is so messy to go through these feeds. Like you're saying, if we're searching Telecom Exchange right now, you're going to get hundreds of images that people are just advertising and things. So to find those gems in social media is really a big data problem, and it needs more automated methods like computer vision, deep learning, machine learning, natural language processing, like very difficult stuff. So I think that to be able to index and categorize on-demand pictures as they're becoming like so many a day, like how many pictures do you post a day online?
Oh, at minimum 200.
Yeah. Oh, okay, that's a lot.
My team.
Yeah, exactly.
As a team.
Exactly. So to be able to process that and make it understandable is such a difficult problem, especially when you're adding like geolocation and if you don't even tag something, like how can we find those pictures?
Right.
So the people that can solve that are going to be contributing a lot to society.
Right. Well, okay, so for our viewers out there who definitely want to know more, where can they go?
My website, it's scope, S-C-O-P dot I-O. And we have a free subscription for a month, so you can sign up and check it out if you're looking for some fresh, relevant photos.
Excellent, Christina. Thank you for joining us. And thank you, viewers, for tuning in to JSA TV.